Hello everybody, welcome to today's class on essay writing. As you know, essay carries a good amount of marks in the OPSC, 250. Next. So basically the essay has certain pros. Number one, the essays are basically repeated. Every year you'd find an essay that is repeated. Next, again it is one essay, not like your UPSC where there are two essays. So one essay, it's fine, no issues. Next, essay is super mark fetching. Now if you write a very bad essay, it would hamper your marks, your rank, as well as your selection. Above all, this positive point of the essay is that you get a sufficient 3 hours timing for one essay. Now what you should know is that, first of all, where to write the essay. Basically, I would suggest write the essays of the previous year's question. The previous year's question has already been uploaded over here. And I would request you write essays every Sunday and post it in the group. Now, prior to now let's move on to your time distribution. Now, as you know that your essay has 3 hours time. Within this 3 hour, 2 hours should be focused on writing and 1 hour should be focused on printmaking the blueprint. Now, what is this blueprint? Blueprint is nothing but the rough idea. The rough idea of what you are going to write at an intro, what you are going to write as a body, and what you are going to write as a conclusion. Now, why a blueprint? Now, basically what happens is that blueprints makes your idea presents your idea in a synchronized manner, and it avoids repetition. These are the 2 points that you must remember, that why the blueprint is necessary. First of all, now how do I make the blueprint? First of all, divide your essay into 3 parts: intro, body, conclusion. Now within this 1 hour of the making of the blueprint, think what basically should be your thinking dimension. Basically, this is what I call as the brainstorming. First of all, let's say definition. Basically, if you say whatever it could be, it could be about the food security, it could be about women's safety. Everything has a definition. Even if it's education, everything has a definition. At least you should know the basic things. For example, I would say go for the definition of education, go for the definition of justice. Just this thing should be in your mind so that you do not have to frame any meaning or make any kind of an absurd statement. Next, subject matter. For example, what the essay is trying to basically what the topic is all about. For example, it could be the food security in India. Now in this context, basically what you can say, there is a means, what actually is the scenario of the food security? How exactly are you going to analyze this? See, first of all, any subject that could have a pro, next it could have a con. Next, there must be some government initiatives that you need to pick it up during the blueprint preparation. Next, what can be done? Where are we missing? These things also has to be put into mind. Last but not least, the conclusion. Conclusion basically saying the way forward, solution, your opinion, and someone else's opinion. Now let me completely this show you this through an example. Let us see the food security. Now basically what I would do is that the food security scenario in India, let's make it a bit more complicated. Food security scenario in India. First of all, I'm going to think of an intro. Now what exactly I'm going to think in this intro? First of all, let's get out the keywords. The keywords is your food security. Again, the keywords is your scenario in India. Hence, I'm going to discuss the food security scenario in India. In this intro, basically what I'm going to write is about food security number one and the food security scenario in India. Is it good? Is it bad? This, that, and all. But basically, I would say never start your essay with a conclusion. The food security scenario in India is very bad because there is prevailing malnutrition. Such kind of statement should not be put in the starting of an essay. Similarly put, what is the food security scenario in India? For example, that the government has such initiative, that is the National Food Security Mission, providing this, that, and all for them. Then move on to the analysis. Analysis means, let's say, this is basically your body part. Within this body, let's find out that how is this food security? First of all, what is this food security? what are the basic things that it is being, that it is addressing. It's addressing malnutrition, it's addressing women empowerment, and now think how food security is related to women empowerment. Next, how food security helps in tackling of the hunger, how food security helps in the growth, how it helps in building up the human capital, its effect on health. See, these are certain things that you need to think about. You can just simply write it down and think later. This is your body that should be addressed. Now again, within this body, what you need to know, that what are the problems? Do we have certain challenges in implementing this food security scenario? That also needs to be put in your mind, that what are the challenges we are facing while implementing the food security. Now let's see, it could be corruption, it could be people's habit. Now what basically I mean by people's habit, that key, see, for example, I would say that the government has already implemented food security in which it's providing rice, wheat at a subsidized rate. But think of a person who is continuously smoking tobacco or who is continuously chewing tobacco. In that case, what the food security is not able to address the health concern, means he is obviously going to have a cancer because of his such habits. Now, can food security somewhat be related with this? You again need to analyze over there. Again, what are the challenges? Challenges in its implementation. Let's go for the corruption. Let's go for that key. The beneficiaries are not added. Beneficiaries are missing. Or you can see that the Aadhaar linked problems. This I can highlight, that sometimes the Aadhaar are not being the Aadhaar, that is a problem with the fingerprint. Basically, the fingerprint or the biometric, it's not able to identify the beneficiary. Now, such things has to be done. Now, first of all, what's the food security is addressing? What are the challenges that we are facing? Last but not least, what can be done? Or the way forward. Over here, what you need to do is that you need to give your own idea that this can be done and this can be done. We can introduce food coupons. We can go for, again, we can go for the food for work. Again, we can go for the food for, food for work is one more initiative. Now, this means out-of-box thinking is necessary over here. And then you can also recommend that some committees, what are the recommendations that have been made by certain committees and all, committee recommendation. This, that, and all. Now, within this scenario, remember one thing. Always be optimistic. Means, yes, there is always a chance to do better, that we can do better, we can do this, we can do that. Never be pessimistic that this food security scenario is so bad that we are going to die, we are going to do this, we are going to do that. Never be pessimistic. Always be optimistic. Find optimism anywhere. Again, what you need to do is that, first of all, what to avoid. Number one is that, within this what to avoid, avoid the harsh criticism of the government. Avoid harsh criticism. The government is incapable. Such statements should not be mentioned. Government, anything against the government shouldn't be mentioned. What we can do is that we can use the constructive criticism. How we can use constructive criticism? Let us see, like I said in the Aadhaar based example, what in the Aadhaar, that certain loopholes are there within the Aadhaar. What are these loopholes? That the Aadhaar, biometric authentication system, it's basically failing to identify the beneficiary. Now, this is constructive criticism. You shouldn't write the government has failed to implement the scheme properly, and that Aadhaar biometric is not identifying the beneficiary. See, this is the word that you should keep in mind. Next, avoid grammatical error. Please avoid grammatical error. And last but not the least, avoid spelling mistakes. Again, people, what they do is that they do not give space between the paragraphs. The paragraph has to be written with clarity. Again, space. Now, why I say, see, Some of you would say that, sir, the new paragraph format has been like this, space and then this. See, basically I would suggest you to follow this format. Why this format? First of all, the OPSC still is in a very orthodox position, and we basically do not know how they are going to react with this new trends. So this style of writing paragraph is quite suitable, and it's quite also, I would say, convenient, at least for the examiner. When he will be checking your essay, when he sees that you have written in such a format that there is sufficient space, intent has been maintained, he would obviously be happy with your paper. At least you would say, nah, at least the paper is readable. Second is that, do not go for clumsy handwriting. At least whatever you write, it should be readable. Remember that. Whatever you write, it should be readable. Do not go for this means writing something like this, writing something like that. Means write the spelling in a proper manner. Never means try to, means what to say, means write the words properly, I would rather say. If you're writing a word, write it in full, full words should be seen, and it should be mentioned. Next, what to do? See, pick up the previous year's essay, like I said in the beginning, and start writing. I think it has already been posted in the group. Please check it out. Next, write essay regularly, at least once in a week or two in a week. Next, essay written has to be self-evaluated first. It means you have to first check what you have written. How to do that? Add a page within the essay only. Add a page, write about your mistakes you have done, and then what points you have left, and only then scan the essay and upload it on the group. Only then we will be checking your paper. Do not take this as granted that whatever we write, there is someone sitting over there to check. No, this initiative is for your improvement. Write the essay, again go through your own essay, at least write down in a page that what mistakes have you done or what points have you left, and then give us the essay. Then we will give you a proper checking. That is the only way you can develop. Never do that. See, anyone who has not given a self-evaluated sheet, the essay will not be checked. I will say this to Dhiraj sir, that he is not going to check any essays that has not been self-evaluated. Self-evaluated essay, then give it. After they have checked, again go for the evaluation. Only by looking at your mistakes that you can know that where you have to improve. Until and unless you know your own mistakes, you can never improve. Next, basically what I would suggest is do smart work. Write down previous year's question essays. Write down the best essay that you can find, and then post it. Do not go for any other topics. Write down the previous year's questions. Obviously, there would be a question from the previous years, and that would be helpful to you. Do the smart work. No need to go for the hard work. Write essays regularly, and remember one thing: if you are posting within this group, do not think in mind that, oh my God, my essay is so poor. What the other guy is going to think? The other guy is going to think bullshit. You do not need to think of this bullshit. What the other guy is going to think? If you think of such things, then what the thing would happen is that you would not be able to improve yourself. Do not need to think what the other guy will think. Write your essay and post it. Be courageous. Only then you can improve. No one is allowed to make personal comments. Only we would be giving you comments. No one else would be allowed to make personal comments. If someone has written a very good essay and you have written a very bad essay, then I would suggest go read his essay. Try to write like him. If you think that his essay is so good, then we would make improvement. This is how you make the improvement. There is no other way. Please follow this procedure. And thank you. I think Pulak has, he's the only student who has posted an essay, and no one else has posted an essay. I would suggest you to start posting essay. Just going back to the previous year's question, see, it's 2019. So basically I would suggest that go for 2018, then go for 2017, then go for 2016. Go in a reverse manner. Because basically what happens is that the previous year's questions are basically to be repeated more than any other past year's any question. I hope everything is clear. Please start writing your essays, and thank you.